to meet those objectives, I think we need to address them just as seriously as we address the needs of the children who need remediation. And while I think reorganization may be certainly a benefit, I think I need to have some understanding of how that's going to be able to address those students so that we are able to, you know, have excellence in academics and be able to provide services to students throughout the entire spectrum.
Well, I think that we're going to have this discussion on Rosemary's point, on your point, on all the points we've made when we get closer to knowing the final number. And there we're really going to have to make some hard choices unless some miracle occurs on the financial side, which I don't expect. So we're going to do that. The question is when, and do we reserve enough time to do that? And I sense that a lot of us would like to speak quite a lot more about some of these issues. I mean, just to add in the horse, I've been beating the plan for computers. That's a long subject. The subject you brought up is a long one. That one's a long one. The one you brought up is a long one. So when are we going to do this?
Well, next Thursday. We have Tuesday and Thursday next week with Saturday scheduled for those are on your budget sheet now. I guess my advice would be that all of these issues get complicated when you, my advice would be that we're not going to solve all of them. And that as we go through each cost center and you try to understand, ask questions in the spirit in which obviously you're already doing it, and you go home and think about it, call me, call the principals. We'll see if we can clarify some of the clarification. Sometimes, for instance, as you think about it, you do set some priorities. And if as a board, after reshaping these things, you set a clear priority, fine. That's what your job is. But I am concerned. I don't know what the bottom line is going to be. There's no way we're going to avoid those moving costs. And I can point out in spades, and I will on Tuesday, that actually is a very inexpensive way of this system solving for a fairly limited period of time, admittedly, but still a better period of time than going out and renting 3 portables, et cetera.
I'm convinced of that.
I know you are, but there's no way you can cut. I mean, you may be able to shave some of these accounts. I think that's always possible. We can always rethink chunks of money that are in there. You point out, for instance, the fuel accounts. Maybe we can rethink some of those chunks, et cetera. Rethink the computer, and I think it's a good suggestion to give you a visual picture of what all the requests are. The process is a healthy one for all of us. We begin to realize that all of these chunks have to be in there. When you get through with that, what you can do in general terms certainly by the Saturday session, you should have a feel for it. But as far as solving those problems, no. They're not going to be solved.
Can I just make one positive comment? One thing that I think is wonderful about this budget is the amount of money for staff development and work that will really go to make the curriculum more consistent, more challenging, to really meet the needs of our kids. So that's one positive.
Well, there's another positive thing, too, and it can't be said too often, and that is this really represents an effort on the part of all the administrators to understand what the situation is in which we're working. And I really congratulate all of you for having prepared the budget. Looking at that, and the staff, and everybody involved in it, it really is a good job. Good. Meeting's over. Thank you all very much.
Good job.